new seasons of the critically acclaimed series Mad Men and the Game of Thrones will begin soon. And many are saying we are in a golden age of television. Here with his reviews of some of these hit shows is a man who has been around longer than TV itself, 1860s newspaper critic Jebediah Atkinson.
Thank you, Michael, for that enthusiastic introduction. So good to be back.
So, Jebediah. Have you been keeping up with all these big TV shows?
Of course I have, Michael.
Yeah.
And as always, I think you'll find my reviews to be perfectly moderate and totally rational.
You know, I was worried about that.
All TV is excrement! Mad Men, the most likable character in this show is cigarettes. Hey, AMC, if I wanted to know what life was like in the 1960s, I'd move to Indiana. I've been around a long time. It's never been a great stay. Game of Thrones. Oh, great. A softcore porn with 100 hours of backstory. At least in porn, you know how it's gonna finish. Oh, and George R.R. Martin, you better hurry up and write those books because from the look of you, winter is coming. And House of Cards. The only thing lazier than the writing is Kevin Spacey's attempt at a southern accent. And when he makes those turns to camera, I haven't witnessed shots that jarring since the assassination of Archduke Franz Ferdinand.
Wait, Jebediah, you were at the event that started World War I.
Of course I was, Michael, but I prefer the sequel.
Come on, Jebediah.
Oh, what? World War II wasn't a better war?
That's pretty harsh, man. There must be some shows that you do like.
I haven't liked any television ever! It's been 80 years of mind-poisoning refuse, and I've reviewed it all! Here are a few from the archives.
I'm listening.
Thank you. Want your full attention, Michael. The West Wing. The best lines on that show are the ones that went up Sorkin's nose. Next! Good distance on that one. Cheers, where everybody knows your name from the AA meetings. Next. Oh, and Lost. Sure, it started out good, but I haven't seen a final season that bad since Joe Paterno's. Oh. Hey. If you don't like that joke, just do as Joe did and turn a blind eye.
You don't like anything on TV? What about, like, a classic comedy like Seinfeld?
Ugh, Seinfeld. I'd rather watch Michael Richards do stand-up at the Apollo. That's right, I haven't forgiven him yet. Hey, Kramer, I can say an N-word, too. Next! Keep that for a souvenir. Saturday Night Live. The same tired characters repeating the same tired catchphrases. Next! The Honeymooners. A gritty depiction of a bus driver from the slums who abuses his wife. It's a comedy? And who's the genius who said, oh, this is great, let's turn it into a cartoon, set it in the Stone Age when women had an even harder time? And now we come to the worst television show of all time, I Love Lucy. But I don't think I should do this joke after the audience rioted over the Paterno joke.
You know what? I don't think you
should. Well, I'm gonna do, Michael! It's my thing! I Love Lucy. Hey, Lucy, you got some splaining to do, like why you'd stay married to a man who rafted over from Cuba just to crush your dreams. They should have called this show I Love Lucy's Ability to Get Me a Green Card.
Jebediah Atkinson, everybody!
I voted for Stephen Douglas!